Yes, good morning. My name is K. Ramesh Babu. I am working as Associate Professor in Physics in the Department of Science and Humanities. Today, I am going to give a small lecture on Newton's rings. The Newton's rings are actually formed because of the light phenomena of interference. So, the experimental arrangement to get the Newton's rings is shown here. Here we use a sodium lamp. This is the sodium lamp, and the sodium lamp gives rise light rays in all directions. So these are the light rays coming out of the sodium lamp. These light rays are allowed to incident on a convex lens, and if the sodium lamp is exactly at the focus of this lens, then we get parallel beam of light rays from the lens. So this parallel beam of light rays from the lens, they are allowed to fall on a glass plate, and we keep the glass plate at an angle of 45 degrees. So this angle between glass plate and the incident light rays should be 45 degrees. If it is exactly 45 degrees, then the reflected light rays from the glass plate, they travel like this and they fall normally on this setup. Here we have a setup, and this setup contains a plano-convex lens which is placed over a plain glass plate. So this is the setup that is very important in this experiment. Here we are using a setup of plano-convex lens which is placed over a plain glass plate. And if you take such setup, what happens is an air film is formed between these two things. That means there will be an air film between the lens and the glass plate. And what is the shape of that air film? The air film thickness will be zero at the center, that is at the point of contact, the thickness of air film will be zero. And if you go away from the center, the thickness of air film is gradually increasing. That is because of the curvature of this lens. So this type of air film formed between the lens and the glass plate, we can describe like this. It can be described as a wedge-shaped air film that is rotated in three dimensions. We describe this air film formed between these two lenses, between the lens and the glass plate, as a wedge-shaped air film that is rotated in three dimensions. Now, here we are using this glass plate such that the light rays coming from the sodium lamp, they fall normally on this setup. Then these incident light rays, they reflect from the top of the air film, and also they reflect from the bottom of the air film. That means we will get reflected rays from the air film. The incident rays are actually reflected from the top of the film and also from the bottom of the film. So we will get reflected light rays in the same direction, like this. Okay, and the reflected light rays, they travel through the glass plate and they reach the microscope placed exactly over the glass plate. So this is actually a microscope that is placed exactly over the glass plate. So now what is happening is the reflected rays from the air film, they are reaching the microscope, and we are watching the reflected light rays from the air film through this microscope. So this is the experimental arrangement. Now we will see what happens to the light rays reflected from the air film. To understand that, I will take the magnified view of that setup. So the magnified view of the setup is like this. So this is a plano-convex lens, and it is placed over the plain glass plate. So this is the magnified setup of this particular magnified view of this setup. Now if a light ray falls normally on this setup, then part of the light ray will reflect from the top of the air film, and the remaining part of the light ray will pass through the air film and it will reflect from the bottom of the air film. So thus we are getting two rays from one incident ray. So actually we are getting two rays from a single ray. So this type of method of getting two rays from a single ray is called as division of amplitude. So thus we are getting two rays from a single ray by the method of division of amplitude. Now these two reflected rays from the thin film, they interfere and they may produce either brightness or darkness depending on the path difference between these two reflected rays. Okay, so now we concentrate on the path difference between the two reflected rays. So here we observe that this is the first ray reflected from the top of the film, and the second ray passed through the film and coming back. So if the at this point, let us say this point is Q, let us say that point is Q, at that point, let us say the thickness of air film is T. If the thickness of air film is T at this point Q, then the second ray, you will easily observe that the second ray traveled more distance when compared to the first ray. And what is the path difference between the two rays? We will say that it is 2T, because the second ray traveling T, then coming back to the same position. So it is traveling through the film twice. Therefore, the path difference we can write as 2T. But if you observe closely, the second ray reflected at a denser medium. We know that if a ray reflects at a denser medium, there will be additional path change of lambda by 2. So here, the second ray is reflected in a denser medium, so there will be additional path change of lambda by 2. Therefore, the actual path difference now becomes 2t plus lambda by 2. So that is the path difference between the two rays. And we also know that if this path difference is exactly multiples of the wavelength lambda, that is, if the path difference is n lambda, we get brightness at this point. And if the path difference is odd multiple of lambda, we get darkness at that point. Okay, so we get brightness at this point or darkness at that point, that depends on this path difference. So if the path difference is integral multiple of lambda, we get brightness. And if the path difference is odd multiples of lambda, then we get, of course, odd multiples of lambda by 2. That means if the path difference is lambda by 2, 2 lambda, 3 lambda by 2, 5 lambda by 2, like that, then we get darkness at that point. Okay, so I will go to that condition later. First of all, I want to tell one more point here, that at the point Q, the thickness of the film is T. Now if you join all the points which have the same thickness, that is called the locus of the points which have the same thickness T, and the locus will be a circle. Okay, here we have to assume the three-dimensional view. At this point we have thickness T, at this point you will have the same thickness T, like that you will have same thickness T around the circular path. Therefore I will say that the locus of the points which have the same thickness T is a circle. Therefore we will get either bright circle at Q or a dark circle at Q, and that depends on the path difference. Now so we get bright circle at Q, so we get bright circle at Q when path difference 2t by lambda by 2 is integral multiple of wavelength lambda. So if the path difference is 1 lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda, then we get a bright circle at this point. So for bright circle 2t plus lambda by 2, okay, I will write like this, for bright circle at Q, so I am considering the point Q, for bright circle at Q, 2t plus lambda by 2 will be equal to n lambda. So that is the condition for nth bright circle. Okay, and I can write this as 2t equal to, I will take this lambda by 2 the other side, then you will get 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. So this is the condition for bright circle. So the condition for bright circle is given by 2t equal to 2n minus 1 into lambda by 2. On the other hand, consider that a dark circle is formed at Q. So for dark circle at Q, the condition now becomes 2t plus lambda by 2 is equal to, I already told you that you will get darkness or dark circle if the path difference is odd multiples of lambda by 2. That means it must be either lambda by 2 or 3 lambda by 2 or 5 lambda by 2, like that. So the condition for dark circle now becomes 2t plus lambda by 2 equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. 2n plus 1 indicates the odd number. So 2t plus lambda by 2 must be equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. Then we get a dark circle at Q. So this is the condition for nth dark circle at Q. Or I will write it as, the same thing I will write it as, I will take the lambda by 2 the other side. Then what you get is, simply you will get it as n lambda. So this lambda by 2 will get cancelled with this lambda by 2. And finally you will get it as 2t equal to n lambda. So this is the condition for dark circle at the point Q. So like this, we will get either bright circle at Q or dark circle at Q. That depends on the path difference between the reflected rays at that point. Now if you observe this path difference, what type of ring or circle you will get in the center? We know that at the center, the thickness of air film is 0. If t equal to 0, path difference delta will be equal to lambda by 2. That means at the center, we will get darkness. So at the center, we will get darkness. And as you go away from the center, the thickness is increasing gradually. And because of the increase of thickness, at one position, you will get a bright circle. And at the adjacent position, you will get a dark circle. Because at the adjacent position, the condition for darkness will be satisfied. So at one position you will get bright circle, and at the adjacent position you will get dark circle. So finally you will get a central darkness at the center, and that is surrounded by alternate bright circle, dark circle. So this type of pattern you will get, and the same pattern you can observe through the microscope. So such pattern is called as Newton's rings. Okay, so that is about the formation of the Newton's rings. Now I want to derive an expression for the diameter of the Newton ring. Okay, now I am going to derive an expression for the diameter of the Newton's rings. To derive that expression, I will consider once again this setup. So that setup is given by, I will take the magnified view of that setup. Once again, I will take that setup, and that setup is containing a plano-convex lens placed over a plain glass plate. So this is the setup, a plano-convex lens placed over a plain glass plate. Now here, this plano-convex lens can be thought of, it is actually a part of the plano-convex lens is actually a part of big circle or sphere. This plano-convex lens is actually part of a big sphere. Therefore, I am taking that sphere here, and let us say that the radius of this sphere is capital R. The center of sphere is C. And the radius of that circle, the radius of that sphere is capital R. Okay, so that is the situation. What I am doing is, I am taking the plano-convex lens, and I am imagining that plano-convex lens as a part of a big sphere. Okay, this is a big sphere of radius capital R. Now let us say that this is the point Q. This is the point Q where the thickness of air film is T. So this is the point P, point Q, where the thickness of air film is T. Then let us this point of contact as O. O is the point of contact. Point of contact of lens and the glass plate. Now just draw a horizontal line at this point Q. So that is the horizontal line at that point. And also join the center and the point Q. Join the center and the point Q, and this point, consider that this point as P. Let us say that that point is P. So this is the cross section of this radius line and the line drawn at the point Q. So this point is say P. That is the situation. Okay, now just remember this equation 1 and equation 2. So this is the condition for dark ring, this is the condition for bright ring or bright circle, and this is the condition for dark circle. These conditions are required to derive an expression for the diameter. Okay, so that is about this equation 1 and 2. Now I am going to derive an expression for the diameter. For that I will continue now. So just observe this figure here. PCQ is a right angle triangle. Here PCQ is a right angle triangle, and from this right angle triangle, in this right angle triangle, this is the CO, the length CO is radius R, and also the length CQ also equal to radius R. Okay, and from this right angle triangle, so from the right angle triangle PQC, from right angle triangle PQC, I can write the hypotenuse square, R square, is equal to this hypotenuse square, R square, equal to square of this length plus square of this length. And what is this length PQ? The PQ corresponds to the radius of the nth circle or nth ring. So PQ corresponds to the radius of the nth circle. And what about this PC? PC value will be equal to, this is actually T. PC value will be equal to R minus T. So PC value will be equal to R minus T. So from the triangle, I will write like this. So first of all, I will write like this. From the triangle, QC square is equal to, QC square equals to PC square plus PQ square. So this is simple Pythagoras theorem, and I am writing like this. QC square equal to PC square plus PQ square. But what is this QC? QC is nothing but radius. Therefore radius of that curvature, we will call this capital R as radius of curvature of the lens. Capital R we call it as radius of curvature of the lens, not lens, the radius of curvature of the plano-convex lens. So QC square is nothing but R square, and this will be equal to PC square. And what is this PC square? I told you that OC, the point, the distance from point O to C is capital R, and the distance from O to P is T. Therefore the point PC square, the point PC will be becomes R minus T, and PC square becomes R minus T square, R minus T whole square plus PQ. What is this PQ? PQ is the radius of the, PQ is the radius of the nth ring. So I will write it as Rn square. So here Rn stands for the radius of the nth ring formed at Q. So that is the equation you will get, and this equation will be simplified now. Now it is equal to R square equal to R square plus T square minus 2RT plus Rn square, or Rn square, or Rn square is equal to, or Rn square is equal to, you take this R square this side, they will get cancelled. So we will get like this, Rn square is equal to 2RT minus T square. So we will get Rn square, the radius of the nth ring at Q, Rn square is equal to 2RT minus T square. But we know that the thickness T is very small. It will be very very small. Therefore T square will be further small. So we can neglect this T square comparing with 2RT. Here R is the radius of curvature of the lens, and the R, capital R, is the radius of curvature of the lens. It will be very high. It will be of the order of 100 centimeters. But it is T, the thickness of air film is less than 1 millimeter. Therefore I can neglect this T square. So you will get Rn square simply equals to now 2RT. So I am neglecting this t square. That is the expression for the radius square of the nth ring. Now the diameter square will simply becomes 4, actually Rn I can write it as dn by 4. So it becomes 8 Rp. Okay, so the diameter square becomes 8 Rp. So that is the expression for diameter square. Now I will further continue it here. This diameter square I can write something like this. Here diameter square is given by 8 Rp, but we know that for dark circle or for dark ring, for dark circle or dark ring, 2t equal to, that is given by equation 2, for dark circle 2t equal to n lambda. So I will substitute that expression in the diameter expression. So for mth dark ring, let us say n only, so this is d n square, the diameter square of the nth ring d n square is equal to 8 rt. Now for the nth dark ring, for the nth dark ring, d n square can be written like this. Here I will take 2t as n theta, n lambda, then you will get it as 4 r lambda. So if you substitute this expression, that is 2t equal to this expression, 2t equal to n lambda, in this you will get dn square is equal to 4 r lambda. So from this you will observe that the diameter is given by 2 times square root of r lambda. So the diameter of nth dark ring is given by 2 times square root of r lambda. So like that, here I have to replace 2t with n lambda. So you will get like this, dn square. If you replace 2t with n lambda, you will get dn square as 4 n lambda r. So I am replacing 2t with n lambda. So you will get dn square equal to 4 n lambda r. So that is the expression for the diameter of the nth dark ring. Okay, like this we can talk about the expression for the dark rings, and bright ring also you can find using the same expression. And in the lab we are going to measure this diameter of the different rings, and we are going to find the radius of curvature of the plano convex lens. That is what we are going to do in the lab. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.